physicist Alfred Merx, internationally acclaimed expert for the principles of security in electrical engineering. Today, security is freedom from damage risks, that seem to be unacceptable. This concept of security is now incorporated into the recognized rules of technology at the international, European, and national level for switchgear assemblies and for electrical systems. The switchgear assembly manufacturer, including the one who builds the plant into which the switchgear assembly is incorporated, must adhere to these security rules. However, it may be that, for reasons like, for example, shortcomings during installation, unforeseeable material wear, maintenance intervals that extend beyond the planned period, through these measures, the plant no longer functions in the way you can say it is free from unacceptable damage risks.
Von unvertretbaren Schadensrisiken. Aus diesem Grund macht es einen Sinn.
For this reason, it does make sense, and it is necessary to integrate safety mechanisms into the plant that go beyond the minimum necessary risk reduction and at the same time lie above the European and international standards, so to speak, as a security reserve for the times in which the plant does not run as it was originally planned.
So läuft, wie sie ursprünglich geplant war.
This may be defects in maintenance, in service, and, for example, in some countries of the world, unwanted access of small animals. According to electric arcs, an inadmissible warning may occur whereby the plant is simply no longer free from unacceptable damage risks. For this reason, the security reserve, which is above what is specified in the minimum standards, must be integrated.
Sicherheitsreserve, die über das, was in den Mindeststandards steht, eingebaut werden muss.
Once the damage has occurred, if the low-voltage switchgear assembly can no longer perform its function, manufacturing companies experience a production stoppage. Now here, we consciously do not take into account that personal damage occurred. These production stoppages first result in the fact that there may be changes in the disposal of the products to be manufactured. More or less pleasant or unpleasant talks with customers must be conducted, and that, in the worst case, substitute production must be ensured, which is, of course, associated with additional costs. This function between the duration of interruption and the extent of damage can be predicted fairly precisely in advance with the so-called damage interruption duration function. In the second case, concerning the failure of the switchgear assembly system with which technical communication services are provided, like, for instance, IT systems or server for internet supply, there is an additional problem that the users of such services react extremely sensibly to. The interruptions of these services can even lose trust in their services. And in addition to the loss of their trust following failure of the service, there may be a risk of losing customers because the user decides to choose another provider.
Bearing
responsibility for an electrical plant, for its operational safety, for running operations is one thing. Another thing is to assume responsibility for people, in particular for employees who work in those plants. Here too, international, European, and national standards play an important role. And here as well, these standards reflect the minimum requirements to be met by the design of switchgear assemblies and for the systems connected to these plants. The Austrian employee protection laws, the legal basis for all employers that bear responsibility for employees, are focused on another goal, both worldwide and, of course, in Europe, namely the state of the art. The state of the art for low-voltage switchgear assemblies goes beyond the rules of engineering. This is what the employee protection laws focus on. Here as well, it is about doing more than is contained in the minimum standards, doing more to integrate this security reserve into the plants.